Ministries and government departments have been told in black and white not to seek any supplementary budgets in the next financial year. This was revealed by the Finance Minister, Matia Kasaija, who says that supplementary budgets frustrate government development goals. He made the remarks at the budget review conference that was held at the Kololo Independence Grounds today.
Finance Minister Matia Kasaija says the government plans to give priority to the health sector in the current financial year by allocating more funds for purchase of COVID-19 vaccines, management of the third wave, and supporting economic recovery with reasonable stimulus package. This is why funding supplementary budgets will especially not be possible.
You know, we went, we took a decision, but I think politically, yes, it was good, but when it comes to money, it's a big issue. We created so many units, administrative units. Now funding them is a real issue now. Very big problem. And those of you who know, who are involved in this, you know what I'm talking about. We should have gone phase by phase, but we politicians, at times we put pressure when elections are coming, and at times I cannot withstand it. If I withstand it, then you would knock me down. I'm being told even now the rains have already become very rough. In some areas, especially in Kibale there, there was a heavy rainstorm yesterday. That is unavoidable. Two characteristics. You can't, the thing is not predictable. It is not available. Then we can look for the supplementary.
More money is going to be injected into the oil and gas sector, mineral development, works and transport, tourism, scaling up electricity and internet connectivity, plus other wealth creation programs.
The tourism and tourism. Mineral exploitation and development are critical for Uganda's acceleration process. Investing in mineral development lowers the cost of production, increases the return on investment, and boosts the supply of locally manufactured products like cement, iron, and steel, and fertilizer. Considering tripling tax revenues with COVID-19, this program prioritizes investment for import replacement, export promotion, and improvement in domestic resources.
The government has also announced plans to reduce foreign borrowing and concentrate on domestic borrowing, plus creating new taxes in the trade industry that will generate more revenue locally. Kasaija has directed local governments to start consultations on the new budget from all stakeholders to ensure that everyone is brought on board. Chief Justice Alphonse Owindolo used the event to castigate the Ministry of Finance for allocating meager resources to the judiciary, which hampers dispensation of justice. Owindolo says the judiciary's plans to build a court of appeal in Gulu have been frustrated by lack of funding from government.
I should be able to have a number of upcountry courts of appeal, because today I have only one court of appeal. It is located in Kampala. And the person who comes from Kabong, the person who comes from Kisoro, from Bundibugyo, from Yumbe, has to come up to Kampala. It is costly. It is devastating economically for litigants. So we've started the move to locate courts of appeal upcountry. As you are aware, Honorable Minister of Finance, we made a decision to begin with two courts of appeal, one south of the equator, one north of the equator. The one south of the equator, we want to locate it in Barara. The one north of the equator will locate it in Gulu, the traditional capital of northern Uganda.
Officials from World Bank used the event to caution government against endless borrowing from international agencies as COVID-19 ravages the country. Vice President Jessica Alupo represented the president. She directed the Ministry of Finance to find money for the parish development model and other wealth creation programs.
My Lord Chief Justice and Right Honorable, and indeed all of you, distinguished participants, further emphasis will be put on improving production and productivity to improve farmers' incomes, particularly smallholder farmers, through implementation of the parish development model.
I've been asked to allow General Katumba, with your permission,